Let me just tell you guys, in boxing economics, 1 + 1 = 2. In boxing mathematics, 1 + 1 = 2. So a lot of people were talking today because Ryan Garcia and Devin Haney said after their fight, Ryan said he made $50 million and Devin Haney said he made more than $35 million. I don't know what they made. I haven't seen their checkbooks. I haven't seen their bank accounts. But a lot of fans today were claiming that there's no way they made these kind of numbers because the gate only did $4.3 million. Many times fighters don't even get any money off the gate. The gate goes to the promoter and with the split, and now the promoter gets the parking and the concessions, or maybe $2 of every drink in the concession. Depends. Every deal is different. And some arenas pay you to bring your fight there, and they may give you $1 million, $2 million, $15 million, $17 million. It depends on the promotion. It depends on the fight. Depends on the venue. Some venues pay zero. Staples Center, Crypto Arena, whatever it's called right now, they don't pay for events to come there. Other arenas do. But then there's sponsorships, and fighters many times don't get part of the spot. When you see a sponsor in the middle of the canvas, the fighter doesn't get a part of that. That goes to the promoter. They're putting on the event. They're investing. Fighter gets their base pay. In a great economy, the base pay may be high. In a tough economy like now, it's as low. I mean, obviously the Canelos and the Gervantes and whatever Turkey is paying to people headlining in Saudi may be above market because, you know, Tank is a superstar, Canelo's a superstar. And the Saudis and Turkey, they're investing in their interest in boxing, and they're paying a lot of money. But when it comes to other promotions, regular fights, the premiums of the first amount the fighters are getting on contract is much lower, I think, than in past years just because of the tough economy. So let's say in the past, if a fighter would get $5 million, they're probably giving $2 million right now. If a fighter would get $10 million, they're getting $5 million. Obviously, there's always exceptions, but I don't think fighters get part of the gate. That, again, goes to the promotion. And back in the day, and I'm talking back in the day as of a year ago, 2 years ago, 5 years ago, when there's a major pay-per-view, the first $300,000 the promoter keeps. And anything over $300,000, a fighter could get $5 per sale or $3, something like that from each sale from over, let's say, $300. So if a pay-per-view did $900, so the fighter can make an extra few million off that. Then there's the distribution. The fight airs in 122 countries, and the fighters most of the time don't get a cut or get a very minimal cut of the percentage of that. Some countries pay as low as $40,000. Some countries pay millions. It depends on a country, depends on a fight, and so on. So there's a lot of revenue streams that come into the promoter, but then you have to understand the promoter's the one putting in the risk. The promoter's the one putting on the show. Yes, the fighters get paid, and they get paid well, and everybody wants to box because the big money's in boxing. But the promoters also have to put on a profit because they're the ones putting the risk. They're risking everything. What if a fight doesn't sell? What if the gate doesn't do good? So you can't really tell what fighters made based off a low gate. And they never released the pay-per-view numbers for this fight. But something like if a pay-per-view sells, let's say I'm around 14,000 at $80, I think that's $1 million, something like that. But usually the host, in this case, let's say the Zone, would take half and then the other half goes to the promoter. And then, like I said, they have to start calculating the math, how much over goes to each fighter. So it's very hard to get major, major paydays the way the economy is today. And the way people just steal pay-per-views and everybody streams everything. The other day, I saw a video of LeBron James watching a basketball game, an NBA game, on one of those sites that streams sporting events for free. And everybody said, hey, that's the one we use. LeBron is just like us. So Super Bowl is for free. The commercials are over $1 million. And the Super Bowl does great. But again, it's once a year and it's the best against the best. Boxing is a little, sometimes the events may have a good main event, but the rest of their card is super weak. So they probably have to stack the cards and they have to start doing stuff if they still want to stay with the pay-per-view, which I think pay-per-view is very hard to sell, especially because everyone steals. They have to find a way to pre-sale to guarantee the buys, maybe lower the price, and maybe give people incentives to pre-order the fight. Back to Ryan and Devin. Obviously, Ryan is a big star. Devin, they did everything right. His dad did everything right to get him that position. The Loma fight, I didn't feel that he won, but he got the W, so he became undisputed, and then he moved up in weight and beat Regis. He actually beat Regis, but then Regis said that they put a hydration clause on him. So everybody has their own twists and turns, but now that he's been exposed by Ryan, it's going to be hard for him to repeat a stay, or he's going to have to every fight struggle because people know his weaknesses. Not saying he's done, but it's going to be a hard way up. That's definitely the case. And I don't know if he made over 35 mil. I just don't see the numbers adding up like that. But is it possible? Anything's possible. Do I think promoters would throw all that money at him for this fight? I don't think so. Because the pay-per-view should have been in the millions, and they would have shared, hey, we did a million pay-per-view buys. Just a million pay-per-view buys is like, what is that, $80 million? But I don't think it did a million buys. And I don't know. And then, like I said, all the other numbers, I don't think they give him a base pay of more than 4 or 5 million or 8 million. I don't know. I could be off. But I think the base pay for this fight maybe was just at a couple million, which is still incredible. Hey, you get millions of dollars to fight, but I can't see it being more than 4 or 5 million. And one day maybe the fighters will tell us what they made. Maybe not right away, but anything's possible in boxing. That's what I will say. So the fans today, they were discussing it. They were breaking it down. But I don't think fighters get shares of the gate. So that wouldn't affect their pay. I think most of the pay would come from the pay-per-view sales if the pay-per-view did tremendously well, which we don't know because Ryan did a pay-per-view with Tank, which is one of the greatest pay-per-views of over 1.2, 1.3 million, where Devin's last pay-per-view, we never really got the number, so we don't know what he did. So stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted, but just something about boxing economy. And like I said, there's so many ways of money coming in, and the fighters get their share and the promoter gets their share. Stay tuned. Ellie Sekbek reporting.
Ellie Sekbek reporting.
But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekbek reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekbek reporting.